The Treasurer has warned Australia will pay a price financially if it doesn't adopt a net zero emissions target by 2050. Definitely seems to be a lot of movement on this front. So let's go to Trudy McIntosh now. Trudy, good morning. So what has Josh Frydenberg had to say, or what's he going to say?
Well, Pete, really interesting comments here from the Treasurer, pointing to the financial costs that Australia will face if it doesn't bolster its climate action, in particular moving towards a net zero target by 2050. This will be a speech today by the Treasurer delivered to the Australian Industry Group, where he'll talk about the stakes that Australia faces here and the fact that the global markets are moving in this direction, that Australia will face higher borrowing costs if it doesn't bolster action. This is part of his speech. He'll say, quote, "We cannot run the risk that markets falsely assume we are not transitioning in line with the rest of the world." These comments were put to the Prime Minister in Washington a short time ago. He was asked whether it shows that his government has in fact settled on taking a net zero target to Glasgow, these UN climate talks, which will be so crucial in November.
No, if Australia had made such a decision, I would have announced it. And Australia has not made any final decision on that matter, and we're still, and will be considering further when I return to Australia, the plan. That plan recognises that the world is transitioning to a new energy economy in order to respond to climate change. That is the global reality.
Now, in order to take any such target to these UN climate talks, the Prime Minister will need to bridge this pretty big divide, one in which moderate Liberals in the Liberal Party argue there should be stronger action, but there is pushback from Nationals, including Matt Canavan, who's already taken a swipe at what we've heard from the Treasurer. He says on Twitter, quote, "Global banks that want to control who has a job in Australia should be locked out of our country. Yes, that might mean we pay higher interest rates, but it's worth it to protect our independence." Despite these strong comments from Matt Canavan, there are increasingly signals from Nationals leader Barnaby Joyce that he's willing to strike a deal with Scott Morrison. It's likely, Pete, we will see that once the Prime Minister gets back home from the United States, they'll be able to lock in behind the scenes and thrash this out. The expectation is that everybody has a price, including Barnaby Joyce, and that if Scott Morrison's able to thread this needle, Pete, he can take a bolstered commitment to these Glasgow talks.
All right, Trudy McIntosh, thank you.